Hey guys, Morten Åstad here. Welcome to my channel. Today I wanted to share with you some records that I have been gifted. I met up earlier today at a coffee place with my friends Paul and Kari. They are, or Kari especially, is a friend of mine from my late teens when she became friends with my dad and me while in Denmark, actually. She's Norwegian, but she lived and still lives most of her time in Stockholm in Sweden, and she is married to Paul, who is a Swiss artist living here in Oslo, and they're back and forth. Paul has a record collection that I have yet to see, but I don't know if he's about to sell it or whatever, but they sent me some pictures and asked me if I would like to have some records. And I was not to say no. I could have, of course, but yes, please. I was given this one, which is, of course, Led Zeppelin. It looks like a very nice copy of Houses of the Holy. I used to have all of Led Zeppelin on regular sort of old-fashioned CDs, and I also have still my copy of In Through the Outdoor that I got when I was 8 or 9 when it came out, and I have a box set with that Cornfield with the 4 CDs in it, a compilation. But when I got the big Led Zeppelin boxes, which I think you can just make out one there in the corner, they included CDs and vinyls, so I don't have my old CDs anymore. But I don't have any other vinyl from Led Zeppelin, so I said thank you very much. And I've been trying on Discogs and a couple of places to see what, where and what this is from. Not entirely sure, but it's a German pressing. It doesn't have the what do you call that, cumber belt, you know, that cigar belt, whatever you used to call them, with the information on it. It's a gatefold, and I don't think it is an early 80s nice price pressing or anything like that, because it doesn't have any barcodes on it. So maybe late 70s or something like that, not sure. It looks like it was just basically picked out of a record bin, and I looked at the vinyl, doesn't look used, so wonderful copy of that. And I mean, he's in his early 80s, so having a Led Zeppelin record might not seem that odd. He would have been in his 30s when that came out, right? But this one surprised me a little bit. But then again, he would have been in his 40s when U2 released The Unforgettable Fire. Of course, I recently bought a copy of this at a record fair, typical, just a few months back. But this one is actually even nicer. The vinyl looks, I would say, near unused. There's a little bit of smudge on the inner cover here, but it's much nicer than the inner cover on the one I bought at the record fair, because it had some wear and tear, but here and there it looked like it had a little bit of water damage, to be honest. Vinyl on that one was fine, or I wouldn't have bought it. But the funny thing is, this is actually the exact same pressing. This is a Swedish / Scandinavian pressing from the the same year. It has some Swedish printing logos and stuff down here. So this is definitely a keeper. And so I don't know what I'll do with the other one. And again, this surprised me, but a nice surprise. I have exactly one Deep Purple album on vinyl, the latest one, because I bought that box set. So I used to have a compilation album, I think it was a German EMI Harvest. You see a guitar sort of lying there, and there's some sky or something in the background, or is there a lightning on it? I don't have that anymore. I don't know what happened to it. But I got this one, Deep Purple. So this is one just called Deep Purple, isn't it? Yeah, from 1969. So this would be Mark One, right? It's got that Harvest logo on the cover, like so, because it is a gatefold that has this artwork. Is this something Dante's Inferno? I don't remember, but anyway. And then it's got information on the inner side here. Looked online for what pressing information I could find. It's made in Great Britain. And it actually said that this version that has, you know, the some printing on the labels is there and some isn't there, etc., is from somewhere between 72 and 74, but it wasn't very conclusive. So the original release, of course, was 1969, and I have all of the Purple's studio albums on CD, which I managed to accomplish this year, but I haven't listened to their first three albums that much, so that would be cool to I'm holding the right side up. To listen to on vinyl. And again, vinyl looks beautiful. And the fourth album that I was given, and again, very surprised. I have never heard of this band before. It's Swedish. I asked why on earth he had it. It's an album which is 11 years old, I think. This is a Swedish band, like I said, called Gravmaskin. Gravmaskin, but it's written Gravmaskin anyway, which means digging machine, digger, yeah. And the title of the album is Volume 1, number 1, Volume 1. They only existed for about 3 or 4 years. I've been trying to read up on them. It's not very easy. I've read some old articles online from Swedish newspapers giving them high praise. And they seem to have just disappeared a year or two after this came out, which I think this came out in 2013, and by 2015 they were gone. I saw that they actually played here in Oslo, so maybe Benedict and the other guys in Tusmørke knows who they are, because I noticed that they played at one of the festivals, which is every fall here in Oslo, which so what kind of music is it? I've been listening to it a little bit. It's really kind of cool. So far, from what I can tell, instrumental only. It's listed as space rock. It's proggish, a little bit of a film movie theme on it, with a hint of 70s going on there. Six tracks altogether: Sultans of Speed, Roadkill or Carpet, Locomotion, and side B is Fake Blood, Ghosts in the Gas Tank, and Only Corpses and Fumes. So, I a really, really fun surprise. And not only been given, gifted some records. And here is the vinyl. From what I can tell, there are two vinyl pressings of this record. One is American and on black vinyl, and it was between 300 and 500 pressed. And then the other one is this European one on white vinyl, and that's it apparently. And 300 copies pressed of this. And yet, if you go on Discogs, you can buy these for next to nothing. And they've gone on to other bands. Members were Sofia Rydahl, Mikael Styrke, och Lukas Heger. And all songs written by Gravmaskin, recorded and produced by Gottfried Åhman, summer of 2013 in Rickomberga, Uppsala. Uppsala, the city of Uppsala in Sweden. So yeah, there's the inner... Well, no. There we are. There's the picture of the band there. And I already showed you the back. So that was a fun discovery today. Being gifted records, having some nice coffee, a nice talk, and coming home and listening to some brand new music, and looking forward to listening to the other stuff. Yeah, and I grabbed and watched a devotional live show of Depeche Mode. Anyway, guys, any comments about this? That would be cool. Other than that, just want to say thanks for watching. Please click like, please subscribe, and I hope to see you soon in another video.